few minutes on Monday afternoon, the sun is going to be almost completely behind the moon, likely creating the best opportunity in our lifetime to see a near total solar eclipse. Joining us now, Talia Sepersky, the planetarium educator at the Museum of Science. Thanks for being here.
Thanks for asking me.
All right, Talia, so NASA says here in Needham and the kind of the greater Boston area at 3:29 p.m. on Monday, the moon will cover about 92.5% of the sun. So not a total eclipse here, but pretty close. And the one question that we kind of keep getting, what does that mean as far as how dark it will actually get around here?
The sky is going to be dim. It's going to be dimmer, but it's not like it's going to be totally dark. It's not going to look like nighttime. You're still going to be able to walk around outside. I know that 8% of the sun doesn't sound like a lot, but that is actually still a lot of light that's going to be coming down.
Yeah, the sun is very bright. Okay, so what else should we expect to see?
Well, if you have eclipse glasses, if you have a safe way to look at the sun, you will see it as a thin crescent. And if you're not looking at the sun, you will notice there's going to be differences in the light. Shadows are going to have sharper edges because, you know, when the sun is a full disk, it sort of softens the edges of the shadows. They're going to look a little sharper. If you create a pinhole camera, or if you do, there's a fun trick you can do with a colander, where if you just sort of hold the colander up and then look at the light going through the holes, it's going to look like a crescent. Because the sun is going to be a crescent in the sky at that point. And it is going to be a little dimmer in the sky. You might be able to see the planet Venus in the sky. Yep.
Okay. So we obviously understand why it'll be getting a little bit darker in the middle of the afternoon. What about the rest of nature around here? Do you expect, even though we're not in the path of totality here in Boston, that the eclipse might trigger some odd behavior among our animal friends?
Yep. We are going to be far enough into the eclipse that we are past the threshold where animals are going to start to notice the difference in the light. It's not going to be anything dramatic. You're not going to, you know, see any animals panicking or anything like that. But you may hear the birds start to sort of quiet down the way they do, you know, towards the end of the day. If you've got animals that have a certain nighttime routine, they may start that routine because the dimmer light to them signals that the day is ending. And then they might be a little bit confused when the light starts to increase again on the other side of it.